Kiss me, my darling. Be mine tonight. Tomorrow will be too late. It's now or never. My love won't wait. It's now or never. My love won't wait. It's now.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today in the City of Lights, Las Vegas, Nevada, here at the Little Graceland Chapel on August 16th, 2022. We're here to celebrate a promise. A promise that was made by this hound dog Ross and his love me tender Lisa. Now I can tell by the looks on their faces that their honeymoon is going to be all shake, rile, and roll. So let's get down to it. Do you, Ross, promise to...
She's the wrong one.
What?
She's the wrong one.
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure.
Does she know this?
I don't know. I mean, I think so.
So where is your woman?
I don't know.
Well, do you want to marry this one?
What? No.
Why not? She ugly?
No. No. She's actually very attractive.
So what's the problem, Slick?
Are you kidding me? That's not my bride.
Yeah, but she's a bride. And by the looks of things, she's ready to rock and roll.
Look, I am not marrying a total stranger, all right?
Why not? That's the Vegas way. Come on, take a gamble. Roll the dice.
I'm gonna roll the dice? This is marriage we're talking about. It's a sacred bond.
All right, your funeral.
You mean wedding?
Is there a difference?
Yeah, I think so.
Not really. You're standing in some kind of church, wearing a suit, surrounded by flowers and organ music. There's a ceremony, there'll be tears. There's a reception with food, drunk guests, family feuds, and at some point, somebody's gonna poke somebody else and say, "You're next."
Actually, that's disturbingly accurate. But what am I gonna do about her?
And you're sure you don't wanna marry her?
But what? Yeah, of course. I don't even know her.
You booked the chapel for 45 minutes, so there's still time. I can take a walk. And...
No. I guess... I gotta go call it off.
Well, that's gonna upset her. Don't be cruel. She got a heart so true.
Why is she gonna be upset? She doesn't even know me.
Yeah, but she's here.
That's a good point. Why is she here?
Let's go find out. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today in the presence of God and the King himself to witness the marriage between Ross and...
Sadie.
And Sadie in the blissful sanctuary of marriage. For love is the most...
Excuse me, Sadie, right?
Yeah.
Do you know me?
You're Ross.
Yeah, that's right. How'd you know that?
Because Elvis just said it.
Right, yeah, of course. Okay. Are you sure you want to marry me?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Oh.
Can I continue? I got a gig at 9 down in Liquid Dreams. Right. Do you, Ross, promise to cherish...
It's just that... I don't really know you.
Well, I don't really know you either.
That's true, Ross. And yet, she's still willing to marry you.
Yeah, but... Come on. You don't love me.
Oh, I think I do.
You do?
Sure.
As I was saying, do you, Ross, promise to cherish...
It's just that...
Oh, come on, man. You're stepping on my blue suede shoes here.
Does everything have to be an Elvis reference with you?
What are you talking about? You're standing on my shoes.
What? Oh, I'm sorry. Sorry. But anyway, Sadie, don't you think this is kind of a big commitment?
Yeah? Why, don't you?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Which is why I'm questioning why you would want to marry me.
Ooh, sounds to me that you might have an issue with marriage.
It does sound that way, Ross.
What? No, I don't.
Maybe he's getting cold feet.
It does look that way.
What are you talking about?
Oh, maybe he's got a phobia of marriage.
I read about that. You got sweaty palms, feel dizzy, you got any trouble breathing? You got any of those symptoms?
I can't say I do.
Yeah. That's the main one.
Look, this is ridiculous. I'm supposed to be marrying Lisa.
Oh, she left.
Yeah, she... What?
Yeah, she left about 5 minutes ago with some guy in a Hawaiian shirt.
She left with another guy?
In a Hawaiian shirt, yeah.
What? Did she say where they were going?
Oh, you know what? They did say something about a chapel of bells.
The chapel of bells? That son of a bitch is stealing my clients again.
Chapel. Why is she going there?
Well, why else do people go to wedding chapels?
She's marrying the guy?
In the Hawaiian shirt, yeah.
But, well, I won't believe this.
I know. That guy over there can't even speak English, let alone sing.
Oh, the Chapel of Bells is an Elvis.
He ain't no Elvis. He's a hack. I'd like to kick him in his Chapel of Bells.
Wait. So... You saw them together.
Oh, yeah, they were together. It looked like they were going to skip the wedding and go straight to the honeymoon.
What? But I only left it alone for like 2 minutes.
Oh, yeah, it was like an intense 2 minutes.
Fuck!
Oh, yeah, that definitely seemed like where they were heading.
Sounds like a passionate couple.
Oh, they looked very much in love.
What? In love? What are you talking about? They just met.
Love at first sight.
Amen.
But how? Ah!
You seem upset.
Oh, you think?
Here, this will help.
Will it, Elvis? Will it really?
I'm gonna give you two a moment. Go fix the pompadour. Elvis has left the building. Well, temporarily.
I don't believe this. It's not even after the fact that she and I dated for 2 years. It's not even after the fact that she ran off with someone else. It's more to the fact that she and I dated for 2 years. But she would rather marry a man she met 2 minutes ago than marry me? I mean, what does that say about me?
Well, it says that you dodged a bullet. I mean, what if you two did get married? It'd only be a matter of time before she met some other guy.
What? A Hawaiian shirt guy?
Well, no, it doesn't have to be a Hawaiian shirt. It could be a bowling shirt or a V-neck.
Look, it's not the shirt. It's what's in the shirt that bothers me.
Well, I, for one, am kind of glad you're not getting married, because now it means we get to get married.
Which brings me to the question of why. Why would you want to marry a total stranger?
I don't want to marry a total stranger.
I want to marry you.
Yeah, but you don't know me!
Isn't that kind of the point? We'll get to spend the rest of our lives finding out about each other.
What did you do? Did you wake up this morning and think, I know, I'm gonna go to Vegas and marry the first person I see?
Yeah.
What? Really?
No, yeah, I thought I'd just leave it to fate.
Just leave it to fate? Whoa, Jesus Christ.
Oh, we're praying now.
Oh, we're not. We... No, 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 we're... What I'm trying to say is, how could you take a gamble on something like this?
Well, the chances of someone finding love on any given day is just 1 in 562, but you can increase those odds by helping fate along, by accepting whatever comes your way. You know, that's how I got my job.
And what's your job?
I'm a florist.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I was picking some flowers in the field one day, and then somebody said, oh, wow, those are very nice flowers. Could I buy them off of you? And I said, oh, yeah, sure. So then I took it as a sign. I picked some more flowers, walked into a bank, showed them my product, and they gave me a business loan.
Wow. Okay, that's amazing.
Mm-hmm. And the bank manager even bought the flowers I picked. It was his anniversary.
Okay. That's an amazing story, mm-hmm. but... Marrying the first person you meet. I mean, that's risky. You could have met anybody.
I know. That's the idea.
Yeah, but you could have met someone crazy. Like, I don't know, an axe murderer.
But I didn't. I met a Ross.
So, you dress up in a wedding dress. Mm-hmm. You walk into a chapel. And then what? What was your plan?
No, there's no plan. Like, I walked into the chapel and I saw Lisa and the Hawaiian shirt guy making out, like, really hard making out. You should have seen it. Her tongue was so far up his ear.
Okay. I get it.
She's talking about leaving you at the altar. I came here dressed as a bride looking for a groom, and fate delivered one.
So you're saying everything is mapped out for us. No matter what we do.
Well, no. You're talking about destiny. See, destiny controls future events which are deemed destined to happen. But fate?
Fate is the development of events outside a person's control. A possibility of something happening.
Yeah, but if it's destined to happen, then would that be your destiny?
Does seem that way, huh? But no, it all starts with allowing fate to happen.
Okay. Let's do it.
Yeah?
Yeah. I mean, the last few years of my life come for shit.
Exactly.
You know? This could be one of those pivotal moments in my life. An unexpected, smart, and attractive girl who seems to know how things work just walked into my life. I mean, I'd be stupid if I were to turn that down, right?
This is gonna be so much fun!
That's what I'm talking about. A little less conversation, a little more action.
Okay, Elvis. Let's get married.
Well, all right. Assume the positions. Huh. Do you, Ross, promise
well,
to cherish...
Well, if it's not the Elvis imposter...
Imposter? You better watch your mouth, son. Huh.
Boy! Oh, no, you didn't! Ha!
Huh!
Ha!
Huh!
Ha!
Huh!
What is happening right now?
I think it's an Elvis standoff.
Mia.
And that's how it's done. Now, why don't you take your honky-tonk ass out of here? Can't you see I'm busy?
Hey, how much you charge you, huh?
You better watch yourself. I will kick your ass back to the mainland.
Come, I give discount.
Thank you, but I think we're fine. Right, sweetie?
I mean, how much of a discount are we talking about? No, she's right. We're good. We're booked.
Hello. I have 100% success rate, you know? Those who marry at my chapel, I do forever. Not like this pretender.
What's he mean?
It's nothing. Okay, go on now. Shake your tail feather.
He got 1D in his rooster.
Rooster? What? Oh, roster.
Yeah, rooster. He got 1D in his rooster.
D?
Divorce, you know, D? D for divorce, D for that, D for Sandy Witch.
I ain't got time for your riddles.
What the couple name again, Ah, yes, Lucinda and...
Hey, I was out to know that she had more traffic passed through her than Route 66.
She was stripper.
Yeah, maybe that was that. But hey, they still got a chance. It ain't over. Until it's over.
Well, if the happy couple will change their mind, I give discount and free egg roll in every wedding basket.
You know what you can do with those egg rolls?
Maybe I already have.
What?
That's gross.
Thank you, but I think we're fine.
Your choice, sister. But let's hoping you not. Are you lonesome tonight?
Stop singing. Don't listen to him.
Hiya. Well, if you need me, I just across street.
Wait!
Yes?
You chapel of bells?
That's right, little man.
I'm taller than you.
Whatever.
Did you marry a couple called, Lisa and... Well, a guy with a Hawaiian shirt.
Maybe. Who want to know,
Me?
Ooh, they want hot couple. He got Trans Am.
I read they're very dangerous cars.
Could not keep hand off egg roll.
Maybe they were hungry.
I'm not talking about food, Peggy Sue.
Look, just go.
My wish is your command.
Yeah, that's not right.
Nobody move!
Lisa!
I said, nobody move.
I didn't, I spoke.
Oh, well, nobody spoke either. Now, where's the cash? Did you hear me? I said, where's the cash?
You said not to talk.
And yet you are. Now shut up and tell me where the money is.
Yeah, babe, I think they're a little confused. Let me try. So basically, this is a robbery, and we're gonna need the money you keep in the safe, cash register, and anything else y'all have on you. Oh, no, not you, Ross. I've already cleared out the joint account.
What?
You fucking kidding me? I marry you two!
Yeah, I know. We also robbed your safe, but we did leave you a tip. It was a nice service.
What? You crazy bitch!
Yep, it's the new me. No more sitting on the sidelines. My life from now on is going to be one fast roller coaster ride.
Lisa, I can't believe you.
Ross, life's too short, and you only get one ride, so make it count.
What kind of bullshit that lady's saying?
It's from the fortune cookie. In your wedding basket?
Ah, yeah. Wise words.
Lisa, this isn't you.
No, it is me. It's the free me.
Now, where's the safe?
Okay, teddy bear, calm down. Nobody wants any trouble. It's back here.
Ring?
But it's my grandmother's ring.
I know, and it's a diamond. Why do you think I want it?
Well, ladies and gentlemen, you've been a wonderful audience, but we gotta go.
It won't be long until you're singing the Jailhouse Rock.
They gotta catch us first. Woo! Hello, new life!
What a bunch of a-holes!
Yeah. Anyway, shall we?
Shall we what?
Get married.
Are you serious? We just got robbed. By my ex-fiancée, no less. I am now completely broke. She stole all of my life savings and his. We gotta go to the police.
Whether we go to the police now or later, it doesn't change the fact that you were robbed, right?
Well, yeah, but...
Then let's get married.
I'm ready to rock.
Are you serious? Dude, you just got robbed.
Man, it's Vegas.
Mm-hmm. You're not wrong there.
Okay. But how? We don't even have a ring.
Perfect.
Okay. Let's do this, huh? Then we go $15.99 buffet at Cheesy Does It. You pay.
So without further ado, it's time to say I do. Ross, do you take Sadie to be your only wedding?
Is that a Trans Am?
Ain't no doubt, brother.
Ooh, that crashed bad. They look like Twisted Pretzel.
Karma's a bitch.
Fate?
Ooh, that is one good barbecue right there. Ooh.
Such a night. The moon was bright. Oh, how bright it was. It really was such a night. The night was alive with stars above. Ooh, when she kissed me, I had to fall in love. But I gave my heart to her, sweet surrender. Such a night. Came the dawn, and my heart into love, and the night was gone. But I'll never forget the kiss in the moonlight. Ooh, such a kiss.